So now let's understand about MongoDB tools. So for example, let's say if you will download MongoDB, so with MongoDB package or with MongoDB software, what all the tools will be downloaded? So let us see. These are the tools which will be automatically come along with your MongoDB component, MongoDB package software. So each and every tools is having different kind of usage, we will see. So I have divided here into six portion those tools. So this is core processes, and under core processes, MongoD, MongoS and Mongo shell comes. So MongoD is our database processing, and then MongoS is our query router. This will be mainly used for sharded cluster, we will see. So at this stage, you don't have to worry about this tools name. We will use all tools whatever is mentioned here in upcoming sessions. At initial stage, just you have to keep in mind about this core processes, and under core processes, three processes are processes comes: MongoD, MongoS and Mongo. MongoD is mainly responsible for database activity, so this will be mainly database. So, and MongoS will be query router, or this will be mainly used for sharded. And this Mongo is a Mongo shell. This is a client. So at the initial stages, you have to understand MongoD is your database and Mongo is a client. So at this stage, we will use only these two things, MongoD as a database, Mongo as a client. So we will we'll run this process and we'll see. For Windows service, it is mongod.exe and mongos.exe you can install. And for binary import and export, Mongo dump is there, Mongo restore is there, bcn dump, Mongo uplog. For data import and export activities, Mongo import tool is there, Mongo export tool is there. For diagnostic, monitoring your database, Mongo stack will be there, Mongo top, Mongo sniff, and Mongo will be there. Read files to manage your big files or large files more than 16 MB, you can or for an structured data you can use GridFS API, which is Mongo files. Now let us understand about MongoDB database. So as I said, MongoD is a processor which is responsible for Mongo database. So let's say if you have to say I want to start my database, what you will start? MongoD process. So let's summarize this. So MongoD is the primary daemon process for MongoDB database. Database is a physical container for collections. So if you could remember our traditional system, inside the database we used to have tables. So here, in this case, inside the MongoD database, you will have collections. So at the place of tables, we will say collections. So MongoD database is a container for collections. And then inside the collections, you will have documents. We'll see. So let's say this is a MongoD database. You may have this collection, collection 2, collection 3, collection 4, collection 5, and so on. So you can have n number of collections inside your database. Now, let's say if you talk about the document, so this is your MongoD database. Inside that, you will have collections, various collections. Inside the collection, you will have documents. Now, what will be document? We will see. Now, documents, sample documents looks like this. So don't worry at this stage. I will make sure everybody will be able to write document, complex as much as we can do. So we have question from Surendra Kumar. He is saying, is document like a Word or PDF? Yes, those are unstructured documents, but here we are not referring document like Word or PDF. We are saying document which follows JSON format. and we will see what is JSON format and how it looks like. Is that fine at this stage, guys? Let me proceed and I will make sure that everybody will understand what is document, how it looks like, how can we create a complex document, and how to use those documents in MongoDB. So just guys, just at high level, documents will look like this. Let me proceed and I will make sure that everybody will understand how to create a document. Now let's analyze some terminology between RDBMS and MongoDB. Just compare. We say database in RDBMS, same thing we say in MongoDB. For table we say collection, for tuple or row we say document, for column attribute or variable we say field, for table joining we say embedding and linking documents, but there is no native support for join. There is no join at all. There is a way around it to perform this embedding and linking documents. So guys, I will show you while creating a schema. Primary key here, default underscore ID is there. Just keep in mind guys, this what happens is if you will insert any document, automatically MongoDB attach one underscore ID field that is unique across your collection. Apart from that, you can define underscore ID as a unique value also. It may have number or character value in it. If we talk about the database server, in Oracle we used to say Oracle or MySQLD, in MySQL here we say MongoDB. In client Oracle we say SQL Plus, in MySQL we say MySQL, and here we say Mongo. So MongoDB is our database, Mongo is our client. Now as I said, we'll understand about JSON and BSON. So what is JSON and what is BSON? So JSON is JavaScript object notation. So what is JSON? JavaScript object notation. Lightweight data interchange format. You know, the weight of this data is very small, and quickly you can transfer from one system to another system. Easy for humans to read and write, very easily you can read write these formats. Easy for machine to parse and generate, so we'll see this thing also. Text format that is completely language independent, so this is very important point guys, text format that is completely language independent. So you can embed this JSON in any other language and it will behave in same way. Now at high level, JSON will have two things, an object or an array. Object, a collection of name value pairs, you can say key or value pair also, at the place of name value you can say a key value pair, and an array like an ordered list of value. So then you can have complete JSON structure. Now keep in mind guys, inside the one JSON object or one JSON document, you can embed another and so on. Maximum you can embed 100 JSON documents in a single document. So keep in mind guys, this is very very important. Maximum you can embed 100 JSON documents while working with MongoDB. Now how it works guys, JSON, you will start with curly braces and end with curly braces, then you will have here key and then value, then comma, key, value and so on. Look at this guys. How array will work? You will have this bracket, middle size bracket, and then value, then comma, value, comma, value and so on. We'll see live of this. What all the data types can be supported? A string, number, object, array, true, false and null. So at high level this is the thing guys. Now what is BSON? BSON is nothing but binary JSON. So the JSON will be in readable format, but BSON will have binary, so you won't be able to read this out. MongoDB usage this BSON documents to store your data internally in the format of BSON. So let me walk you through that. So guys, how can you learn about JSON? So it's very simple, json.org, you can go here and then you can learn more about JSON objects. It's very simple, and even I have taken reference from here. So this is the native place from where you can learn completely about the JSON. Now let's say if you wanted to learn about the BSON, again you can go bsonspec.org. Sorry guys. So you can go to bsonspec.org and you can learn about binary. So if you could see here, JSON, it looks like, this thing. It will start with curly braces and then it will be in human readable format like key and value. But if you see here BSON, it looks like this thing. So you won't be able to read this out. But you can convert with some tools in JSON formats. So you can take reference from here, guys, and then you can understand about BSON and JSON.